سمعتك يا هذا عمر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، وانصرنا اللهم على من عادانا. اللهم ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا رب العالمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. وأصلي وأسلم على مبعوث رحمة العالمين سيدنا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، وعنا معهم إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him, and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him, and he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected brothers and sisters in Iman, today's khutbah inshaAllah will be under the title of a warning not to be from the followers of Qarun. Qarun is a very important character in the Quran. Allah used Qarun to highlight very, very important messages. So I'm standing before you now to warn myself and my respected brothers and sisters. Not Qarun did a lot of things. I will be highlighting just on one aspect of the Qarunic mentality, if I may put it in this way.
There is a methodology and a mentality that Qarun was using, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala highlighted some of them. Now, just for your information, Qarun was from the people of Israel. He was living in Egypt with the children of Israel at the time of Musa alayhi salam. And as we all know that Yusuf alayhi salam, we all know the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. Joseph, peace be upon him. The starting and his amazing story from being a slave into the minister of finance and minister of agriculture. That led, and we know from the Quran, that he welcomed his family. So they lived in a very nice time, historically, not Quranically. We know that after a few hundred of years of time, everything was changed. So now the people of Israel, they were hundreds of thousands, maybe millions, tens of thousands, they were big number. Historically, it is believed there's about 400 to 500 years between Yusuf and Musa alayhi salam. So you can imagine if according to their sources, so I can't affirm or affirm, so they, it's claimed they came with 72 persons and they left Egypt with around 1 million plus. However, regardless, about 500 years, children of Israel, they were in Egypt. They were in a very nice status, then everything changed, they became enslaved. Historically, it's not my point how this change happened. However, when Musa came, this is my point, generally the children of Israel, they were under the very tyrant, totalitarian, bad, paganist system regime of Pharaoh. We all know that. This is very clear in the Quran. Can you imagine now? One from the children of Israel who are tortured, who are facing all kind of miserable life, was very close from Pharaoh. So we are talking about a character of traitorship, a tyrant, Kha'in, Amil, Waqih, Mujrim, criminal. His people, they are suffering. So he was close from the authority and was very, very rich. My point now is not everything Pharaoh did. I want just to take part of what Allah warned us from the mentality of Pharaoh, because in my point of view, from my analysis and my observation, I discovered that many of us, we do part of the methodology and the mentality of Pharaoh, that I will highlight it in a few minutes. Qarun, Jazakumullah khair. Now, in the introduction, let me just bring to your attention the important facts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made more or less third of the Quran qasas, stories. And he said in the Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. In their stories, there is truly a lesson for people of reason, people of intellect, people who are reflecting. So Allah is not mentioning stories for the sake of entertainment. No. The Quran is not entertaining TV show. Hasha subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah does not bring from the stories out of millions of stories, because no one knows the age of humanity. And in our deen, we know that Prophet Muhammad told us, when he was asked about prophets and messengers, the number of them, he said the prophets, they were 124,000 prophets, and the messengers, they were 315. Can you imagine? So we might be talking about hundreds of thousands, the age of humanity. So stories could be millions. So Allah decided to choose out of these millions of amazing, powerful, influential stories, some of these stories for a reason. One of the reasons, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَ. There is a lesson, there is a wisdom. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. And in another place, فَقْصُصِ الْقَصَصَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. So narrate to them stories of the past, so perhaps they will reflect. So when we reflect, we do tafakkur, reflect upon deep, thorough thinking about this, we will take lessons. In light of this, I will tell you part of the story of the Qarun, then I will highlight the point that I want to make the focus on. إن قارون كان من قوم موسى فبغى عليهم وآتيناه من الكنوز ما إن مفاتيحه لتنوء بالعصبة أولي القوة إذ قال له قومه لا تفرح إن الله لا يحب الفرحين. Indeed, Korah or Korah or Qarun was from the people of Moses. By the way, when I was preparing, I read the majority of, or a good number of Mufassirin. They had some narrations that he was the cousin of Musa. He was not anyone. And many narrations that he used to be a professional in reciting the Torah. He was not just a rich man. Knowledge, prestige, connection, tribal supports, connection with the most important person in the people of Israel, Musa alayhi salam. Which means he's not just an ignorant in the margin of the, so what he was, because he was, you know, under the influence of the drugs and he had no other choice but to deal with the security forces of Pharaoh. No, it was not the case. He took a decision. He knew what he was doing. Indeed, Qarun was from the people of Moses, but he behaved arrogantly towards them. We had granted him such treasures that even their keys would burden a group of strong men. Some of his people advised him, do not be prideful. لا تفرح. No, لا تفرح means لا تتكبر. Don't be arrogant. Don't be prideful. Surely Allah does not like the prideful. الله لا يحب المتكبرين. Allah does not like, which means Allah hates this act. Be careful. The fact that you have the money. Now, Allah continues, وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ وَلَا تَبْغِي الْفَسَادَ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. Rather, seek the reward of the hereafter. Your priority, this is a message for us. The story basically is for us now. Because when the Quran was revealed, this incident has already finished an average 2,000 years before that. Because this story, historically, Musa lived 3,400 years from now. So this story revealed to Muslims 1,400 years. So when this story revealed, Qarun and his people and all of those people 2,000 years before everything was finished. So who supposed to be benefited from this? Qarun? Definitely not. It's us. So I'd rather seek the reward of the hereafter. Now the believers from these people are reminding him, depending on the teachings of the revelation came through Musa alayhi salam. وَابْتَغِ فِيمَا, this is message for us. Seek the reward of the hereafter by means of what Allah has granted you without forgetting your share of this world. Now the equation Islamically now, on faith based, what you have, what is the priority where to spend? 80% for the akhirah, 20% here, or 90-10, or 70-30. If it became 70-30, you are in big trouble. It became 80-20, still a trouble. If 90-10, still a big trouble. If 95 or 100-0, it's a disaster. So what تَغِ فِيمَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَى نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. By the way, even the sound itself gives the idea. Even the tajweed itself. وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَى. As if you know, okay, by the way, don't forget. This is the target. Oh, by the way, don't forget the dunya. Okay, يعني manage yourself with something. Take a snack with you. Okay, have a piece of sandwich. But the big meal, the big festival there. ولله المثل الأعلى. قال rather seek the reward of the hereafter by means of what Allah has granted you without forgetting your share in this dunya. And be good to others as Allah has been good to you. Do not seek to spread corruption in the land, for Allah certainly does not like corruptors. Now, here comes my point. In this context, with this criminal, with this tyrant, with this arrogant person, look what he said when he was defending himself arrogantly against the believers. The believers now, they represent iman, they represent faith, they represent the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the law of Allah. They are just reminding him, like you and me, if we are reminding, you know, a ruler, Muslim ruler, telling him, do, we are just speaking on behalf of the Quran, exactly. Look to his reaction. Here is my point. قال إنما أوتيته على علم عندي. Period. What was his reaction? He said, he replied, I have been granted all this because of some knowledge I have. Another translation, he said, indeed, it was only brought to me on account of knowledge I possess. Here comes my point now. How many of us, without paying attention, we might keep living, being happy, spreading the good news about achievements, doing many things in our life without attributing that every single point of rizq has come just by the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not because of my knowledge, not because of my aql. How many of us sometimes, mashallah, is very clever. When you come to him, mashallah, how did you manage to do this and this? You know, alhamdulillah, it's very easy for me, peanuts. But where's Allah from this equation? Where's alhamdulillah? Just a small car accident, like this, I become crazy. Lost my mind, khalas. Khalas. Bodybuilding, world champion, I achieved, mashallah, mubarak, dunyala. How did I achieve this? You know, since I was five, my father used to teach me, I'm doing, you know, bodybuilding, and I'm doing. Hey, say alhamdulillah. It's just by the help of Allah. I need no more just the peel of a banana just to slip on the on the stairs of my house 6 months with a broken backbone. I will be paralyzed completely without just the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and nothing. So how many times you forget? I'm not talking the one who might be falling in some of this. He is exactly what I have like Fir'aun. No, he might be like Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he talked about sifat al-munafiqeen, he said such and such and such, وَمَنْ كَانَ فِيهِ خَصْلَ كَانَ فِيهِ خَصْلَةٌ مِنْ نِفَاقٍ. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described the pure hypocrites, he said when he gives a promise, he breaks the promise. وَإِذَا وَعَدَ خَانَ. He, you know, you backbiting, he breaks the promise, he does something against, and he mentioned many characteristics of the pure munafiq. He said, if any one of the Muslims had one of those, he has some characteristics of the munafiq in him. Be careful, cleanse it, leave it, stop it. It's not, does not mean you are a munafiq, it means be careful. You have a share ground with a munafiq. The same thing, we need to be careful not to share qarun with this. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. You know, Allah gave him the money to his described. قال ما إن مفاتيحه لتنوء بالعصبة أولي القوة. العصبة, to the majority of the scholars, between 3 and 9, which means 7 men. Some scholars they say 40 men. Some scholars they say 12. But a group of men, just the keys. Can you imagine? The keys of the doors of the treasures needs about 7 to 10 very strong men, min ulil quwwah, just to hold the keys. Can, in our language now, in our words, he's a multi-trillionaire, not a billionaire, multi-trillionaire. He owns billions and thousands of billions. It was very powerful. Now, the power of the money, it was his rizq. Now he used this to be connected with the power of politics. The power of the security power, the regime of Fir'aun. And he decided completely to neglect his people, people of faith, people of Israel. At that time, they were the only believers in Egypt at that time. The only believer, he knew that. Look how many times this could be applicable on some of us, including myself. Sometimes that's for the type of racism, tribalism, nationalism. Do we do this or not? Look to what problems that happened between many Arab countries after Sykes-Picot. Many of us, we are ready to fight our brothers in Islam and to hold this kind of hatred and to attack them. Look to what happened between Jordanians and Palestinians, between Syrians and Lebanese, between Egyptians and Sudanese, between Moroccans and Algerians. Look, I mean, it's countless examples wherever you go. Racism, we talk racism, we drink it with water. Wherever you go, you find this problem. In the same country, north and south, Shamal and Janub, in the same area, فلاحين ومدن, you know, farmers, The people, the high civilized people, wherever you go, this is part of the mentality of Fir'aun. You are a Jordanian or Palestinian or Egyptians or Sudanese because you decide, no, it's French and the British, they decide to make you as such. What was the difference between Syrians and Jordanians now? Nothing. It was just open area. It was not as at the time of the Ottomans, Amman, the capital of Jordan, it was part of Damascus. Can you imagine? It was part of Damascus. The city of Damascus was taking care of an area, includes Amman. The city of Salt, it was part of Nablus. So size, I'm giving you an example. Can we be applying part of the mentality of Qarun? Yes. Racism depending on the money. This is his power, it was money. But sometimes the power of intellect, clever. You see people, for example, any person. When we raise up our children at homes, mashallah, he's excellent in math. He's genius. He's abqari. He's genius. Without planting the seeds, Habibi, you are genius in math because of the blessings of Allah. Be careful. Anytime you might use this, be careful. When we do not raise our kids that the fact that you are clever or genius in math, it's because the blessings of Allah, not because just you are genius. He will be another copy of Qarun. You can't speak with him. When you sit with him, he just speaks about himself. He does not recognize anyone around him. He will make laugh of anyone trying to achieve something with him. Stupid idiot. You know, no, you can't do it. Don't worry. You don't do it. This is how sometimes we might be creating our kids just because he is clever. Clever because of the father blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have the money, connections, whatever. Otherwise, we might be part of the mentality of Qarun. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. He attributed all kind of favors to himself. His power, his tribe, his mentality, his intellectual power, his relatives, his money, his business skills, whatever. Allah is not part of the equation in his thing. How can we be falling in this trap? Yes. So let's be aware not to fall in this trap. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فلا تفوز المستغفرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. Respected brothers and sisters, just to give a brief and to sum up a conclusion, my point is just be careful, warning not to adapt part of Qarun's mentality. This is the idea. Now in the margin, I will highlight something, I did it many times before, but just to complete the image so as not to lose some of the understanding from the concept. When we talk about the arzaq or the rizq, many times we said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distributed the provisions, the rizq in his way, number one. We are not equal in the type of arzaq. Your provision in terms of money could be better than me. My rizq in the physical muscle power could be better than yours. You and I rizq in terms of the connections and the tribal support could be better than him or they or them in this time. Your project, your size, your color, your nationality, your wife, your kids, how many of them, your IQ level. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distributes this type of arzaq. So number one, arzaq, rizq, or provision is not just money. It could be the health, could be the connections, good relations, the power, the understanding, the power of intellect. All of these are rizq, number one. Number two, Allah distributes in His, according to His wisdom, not necessarily to be equal. Now, the most important point, after accepting the reality, whether we loved or not, Allah distributes the arzaq by His wisdom. Now, accountability will be depending completely on the level and the amount and the type of rizq that you have been provided. For example, Imagine I myself, I was born in the house when my father was the prime minister of my country. So since I was born, I have full access to what happens in reality. I have access to know everything happens in the country in reality. When I became a teenager, because of the power of my father, the prime minister, I have the power to speak with all of security leadership and to push them to do and not to do because of my father. When I know that this is right and wrong, haram and halal, my accountability, if I passed away in the age of 25 and my father was a prime minister for 10 years and I had all of this access of knowledge and power to influence, to protect, to make a shield, and I did not do any kind of khair, rather I used the power of my father to do injustice against everyone. Do you think my accountability will be like someone who was born in a very poor area, did not have even the opportunity to go to school or to university? Hardly he was able to work in a very simple, humble work just to feed himself and his small family. And he passed away after this. So his test, his rizq was very limited from one angle in terms of power, connection, authority and money. Maybe he was given the best wife, the best mother and the best. He was poor. His test was he was poor. So if he rejected this test, he might be a kafir by rejecting Allah's rizq. If he accepted this, he will pass away with the little, you know, test he faced. For me, I had the opportunity to stop injustice. I knew that my father was in charge, for example, of torturing many people just because they are rejecting corruption in my country. I knew that. I was able to stop it just by speaking with my father. I did not care. So I'm holding the responsibility of everyone was tortured because I had the power to stop it, for example. So if I passed away in the age of 30 and that poor man passed away in the age of 30, what I will be held accountable is 10,000 times than him. In our calculations, oh, Diallo, oh, I wish if I were him, he is the son of the prime minister. La habibi, Jahannam is waiting for me. Wallahi, mashallah, he's a multimillionaire, habibi. Say, Ya Allah, protect him to pay the zakah and the sadaqah, not to use the money except on what satisfies Allah. More money means more closeness to Jahannam, unless if you control yourself, not to be there, Qarun. What corrupted Qarun? Money. So having the power or the connections or the authority or the money does not mean that Allah loves me or hates me. It's part of my test. Allah knows what my or your test will be. The point, whatever comes to you, from the khayr, from the rizq, and what appears to us that it's khayr, because we consider authority, rizq, khayr. We consider money, rizq and khayr. We consider connections, rizq and khayr. We consider relations and power, rizq and khayr. Use them or admit. At the very beginning, it's ni'mah from Allah, it's a blessing. If I was born in a tribe that counts 100,000 persons, and if I said, I need help, 100,000 will support me. What was my contribution to be born among 100,000? What was? Nothing. It's just a blessing of Allah. So I was given this power. If I use them to torture or to kill, I am another copy of Qarun. If I kept reminding myself that this ni'mah is ni'mah and I used them to stop corruption and torture, I will be like Abu Bakr and Uthman radiallahu anhu. This is simple equation. And this is the idea to be careful. I have to be careful not to be like Qarun qatalahu Allah hadha ash-shaqi. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fa ya fawza mustaghfirin. اللهم ارحمنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك يا كريم. اللهم اغفر لنا وعافنا واعف عنا وتجاوز عنا وارحمنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا عبيدك أبناء عبيدك أبناء إمائك نواصينا بيدك ماض فينا حكمك عدل فينا قضاءك نسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا وغمومنا يا رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر
الإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. Before we say أقم الصلاة, I ask you, one of my, your dear brothers, he lives with us and he prays with us all the time. He's with us now, but he asked me not to expose his name. One of his relatives, a female, she's fighting cancer and she might not live more than a few weeks. Medical wise, they told her, you have very short time, you will die. So he asked me to ask you, please remember her in your dua, inshallah. You don't know which one of us might be from those who are considered in our Islamic terminology, mustajab al-da'wah. Someone that Allah loves him, sorry, and his dua will be accepted, inshallah. Wa aqim as-salah.
بارك الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين إن قارون كان من قوم موسى فبغى عليهم وآتيناه من الكنوز ما إن مفاتحه لتنوء بالعصبة أولي القوة إذ قال له قومه لا تفرح إن الله لا يحب الفرحين وابتغ فيما آتاك الله الدار الآخرة ولا تنس نصيبك من الدنيا وأحسن كما أحسن الله إليك ولا تبغ الفساد في الأرض إن الله لا يحب المفسدين قال إنما أوتيته على علم عندي أولم يعلم أن الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. فخرج على قومه في زينته قال الذين يريدون الحياة الدنيا يا ليت لنا مثل ما أوتي قارون إنه لذو حظ عظيم. قال الذين أوتوا العلم ويلكم ثواب الله خير لمن آمن وعمل صالحا ولا يلقاها إلا الصابرون. فخسفنا به وبداره الأرض فما كان له من فئة ينصرونه من دون الله وما كان من المنتصرين. وأصبح الذين تمنوا مكانه بالأمس يقولون ويكأن الله يبسط الرزق لمن يشاء من عباده ويقدر لولا أن من الله علينا لخسف بنا ويكأنه لا يفلح الكافرون. تلك الدار الآخرة نجعلها للذين لا ولا فسادا والعاقبة للمتقين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم. إمام مبارك إن شاء الله بإذن